sends and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek.
We're so sorry, skeletons, you're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize,
but I don't think we should.
A spooky, scary skeleton shouts startling, shrilly screams. They'll sneak under sarcophagus and just won't leave you be.
All right, hello, hello, hello. Is this thing on?
I think it might be.
It might be. All right. Hopefully, you can hear Vince louder than you can hear me. You know, probably not though. Cause yeah. If all right, and there we are. Okay. Welcome. It is man. It's been a long time. You know what? Pretty much every podcast has been like a delay. It's like been 2 week delay. You know, but you know, there's been good reasons why because of the delay. It's because the the holidays, and then the before that, I fell asleep and never woke up. But you know, it happens, man. You fall asleep and you don't wake up. Well, I didn't die. You know, I'm still here anyway. Hello. Yeah. So today is episode 33. It's crazy how you know how many episodes there has been. You know, I didn't really expect this thing to blow up and become what it has become, a terrible thing. But
yeah. It's a good thing,
but we're here, man, and let's start off easily by what we usually do is, you know, we can go around the table with two people and talk about video games and fighting games. Well, you know, let's talk about everything. So I've been playing a lot of Hearthstone, been playing a lot of Fallout. A lot's been going on today, and especially watching the video game awards today, which is like ridiculous.
Never watched those, so.
I those are weird, but it was cool, like watching, and then like you know some game, like it's cool not seeing Call of Duty win multiplayer game of the year. That was weird. Like Halo didn't win.
That's a good start.
Or Call of Duty. That was pretty cool. Splatoon won, which was really badass. So.
Congratulations to Yagatsu for winning a best multiplayer game. Congratulations. Good
shit. And then the host pretty much throwing Konami under the bus, which was pretty badass about why Kojima couldn't be there. So yeah, fuck that company.
That's why they're not getting my money, man.
But am I dead? What happened? Oh, okay. Anyway, so fighting game news going around. Dude, I didn't even realize that Capcom Pro Cup is like this weekend.
Yep, it's Sunday.
It's only on it's Sunday, right?
Yep,
that's weird. So nothing's happening Saturday?
I don't think so, at least.
That sucks. I really would. Oh, I don't know. Who cares? Who knows? Who knows? But that's happening, and with that said, there's supposed to be like a special announcement, and then my theory about the special announcement is that they're gonna reveal the last fucking character finally.
And it's gonna be Sawada. It's gonna be sick.
Or Blade. Blade or Sawada would be pretty badass. You know, Street Fighter. But yeah, that's supposed to happen. But then they're also saying that it's not that, and maybe they're just gonna announce the 5 DLCs. But I mean, fuck, dude. Like the game's like what, 2 months away, and the last character or the boss, I guess, was like not announced yet. But who knows? Who knows what will happen? Vince, do you have any thoughts about Capcom Pro Tour Cup and the big news for Street Fighter V?
Yeah, they're just probably gonna reveal the last character. You know, even though the voice file is already leaked, but that doesn't really tell you shit. It's
supposed to be the fan guy, right? Fan, whatever?
Yeah.
Dat fan?
Probably will show the DLC characters also.
Yeah, that'd be
like
pretty.
At a time release, like, who's going to be first and all that shit.
That'd be cool. All right, well, let's just go into that another Capcom program. Who do you think is going to win? Like, you know what? Let's go to who do you think is going to win and who do you want to win? Because I think those are two different things.
All right, well, let's take a look at who's in it first.
Yeah, we probably should do that. Can you link the good people?
Yeah, of course. I don't have it.
The one. we totally got prepared for this, guys. You know, totally new. Oh, Greg.
Oh, you know, hold on. Fucking
come on, man. This picture's pissing me off. Dude. God damn it, dude. Is this supposed to be like the Africa, like the this is like the Africa level, right? Inside the carrier in the background?
No, that's the bracket.
That's not the bracket. That's the bracket. Do you know how to change the link, the URL link? Okay, there you go. Oh, wow, dude, this is so cool. This tournament's so stacked, dude. Let's see who they... Okay, we're going to look at it, and let's... For you guys at home, you can open it, because I'm not trying to... My computer doesn't have a video card, so if I try to, like, region cap this thing, it's probably going to explode.
This is not the correct link.
This is the correct link. Is this not the... Is this it?
Is this not rep?
What are we looking at? All right, anyway, so Momochi's on top, okay, and who's on bottom? Did they even put, like, Daigo on bottom, which
probably
I think...
Probably RB.
You know, Daigo's in the bottom. Okay, anyway, Vince, back to your my question. So who do you think is going to win and who do you want to win?
Who I want to win? Anybody American.
Okay. So who's was that? Knuckledew and... No, Knuckledew, Justin, and Snake Eyes, right? Are those the only three Americans representing? I feel like there's another one.
And Dominion.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Damn, he plays Daigo first round, too. I believe in Dominion, dude. Okay, anyone American? I respect that. Okay. And who do you think is going to win, though? Like, or...
Yeah, take a quick look at the brackets real quick.
How many times are we linking this thing? Oh, number two.
That's the first time, man.
These pictures are so cool, dude.
No, you know what? Fuck that. Fuck America. America sucks. I want Mago to win.
Magoo, dude.
Magoo to win. Who do I think is going to win? Probably Infiltration.
You think Infiltration's gonna win? Yeah, a lot of people are saying that Infiltration might take it too.
He's pretty good.
He's pretty damn good. You know, Strider's an American player. I forgot he's in there too. 801 Strider, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, Will Smoth. Here, let me get you.
So we got Momochi, RB. That's our Lento guy, though, right? That won the fucking. He's sponsored by Razer. Was he always sponsored by Razer?
Yes, he was. And so was Strider. 801 Strider, the sick picture. Look that in the chat.
Come on, grow up, guys. What are you? Can you grow up? Anyway, so Momochi, RB, Punko, Itabashi, Gif, Fudo, Human Bond, Magoo, Dark Jiway. That's the guy that you and Gerald almost fought, right?
Yeah.
Because
he's been old.
Razor, Zien.
I was talking mad shit, dude.
Some guy named Valmaster. I only know one Valmaster, and there's supposed to be a YP in front of his name, but it's okay.
Yeah, it must be an imposter. I don't like it.
Nemo. Dashio. Dashio is the... Is he the Seth player, or is he the...
He is.
Okay. Snake Eyes. Kiyomon. Who's Kiyomon? Is that the guy from Brazil? Or from South America?
Yes, that's the Brazilian.
Who does he use?
Abel. From Brazil.
Oh, shit, there's two Abels in the bracket? That sucks for them.
There's three. Now, Shiro, you know?
Is Shiro in this tournament? Oh, shit. Wow, this tournament is badass, dude.
Yes, it is. I know.
Damn, Dasha Gamer B. Hey, it's so sun. Oh, god damn it. I was gonna say we should just get pizza and watch it on Sunday, but it's my little sister's birthday, dinner. So, yeah, man, fuck her for being born. Anyway, so Valmaster, Nemo, Dasha Gamer B. Gak,
yeah.
the singer from Japan. Yeah. Snake Eyes, I already said that. Kiyomon, Infiltration, Dako, Zhaohai and Dako are not the same person. To be confused. Justin Wong. Tomfi is the Viper, right? From Japan?
Yep.
Tokido, Shiro, Daigo, Dominion, Bonchan, Mise, Zhaohai, Knuckledew, the homie, Luffy, Problem X. Wow, that's pretty cool. Problem X is in there. He's the Seth player or the Buki guy.
Seth.
The Buki guy is F-word, right? Something F-word. Okay. Kazunoko and 801 Strider. That is a badass tournament, and I am really sad that I'm not going to be able to watch a good amount of it. Damn, that's badass, dude. So yeah.
Just watch it at your sister's birthday. I'll be there.
Yeah, dude. Totally.
Me, you, and Felicia just hang
let's
out
see here. I think, you know what? I think. Felicia, Jose Ramirez. I think Momochi and Infiltration are gonna either ticket, and it's cool to see them that they're in two separate sides of the bracket. What I want to win, I want the homie Daryl to win, and kind of want Knuckle Dude to win just because I hanged out with him for like one day.
Yeah, that seems alright. Even though he got scared of Marv, you know, that was pretty cool.
But if I look at this bracket, I think Poonko's gonna fuck people up and like just ruin people's dreams.
It's probably the dark horse, especially the 2 out of 3 portion of it.
I think Nemo's gonna ruin people's dreams. Most definitely,
especially in the 2 out of 3 portion.
Yeah, most definitely Snake Eyes is probably gonna fuck some people up. But then he, I don't know. Tokido most definitely is gonna wreck people. Daigo, Dominion though. That's a. I want like Daigo to do good, and I also want Dominion to do good.
I want Dominion to do well. Cause Dominion.
And then yeah, and then Bonchan, of course, he's gonna do good. I think, and then I don't know, man. This is gonna be an interesting tournament that I can't watch, but it's gonna be sick, dude. I'm really excited. I heard it's gonna be like better than last year. I don't know how that's gonna happen. Maybe they're not gonna have that that band, that cool band playing, and
yeah, there's gonna be no iPad DJ, unfortunately.
So oh, that sucks.
Already upset.
Yeah. It's a 2 thumbs down tournament, man. Anyway, so yeah, so that's in the Ultra Street. This is supposed to be the last Ultra Street Fighter tournament, also too, man. So not last, but I mean the last big one, I guess. But yeah, dude, excited, totally gonna watch it. And yeah, so besides that, there's not that many Street Fighter news in the world. Besides, like, you know, NEC is this week. That's crazy. NEC, damn.
Is it this week?
Yeah, I think NEC is this week, man. Cause that's why I think. Wait, is it this week? No, it's next week. Next week, next week. Because I think they wouldn't be that dumb, right? Yeah, NEC is this next week. Because the world... If you guys follow Tekken, the World Tekken Cup is next week. It's after Capcom Cup. And then... Cause I remember that they wanted Spooky to stream it. But he's streaming NEC. So yes, that is next week. So damn, that's going to be a pretty badass tournament too, man. Dude... If anyone wants to go to a tournament in the East Coast, NEC is probably one of the most badass tournaments I've ever been to. Besides, I can't even think of a funny joke, but besides PRK and TJ, man, you know those.
Yeah, BXG, you know?
Yeah, dude, BXG, Paradise, and some other tournaments that.
Yeah, Paradise is one of my favorite tournaments of the year. I think that's the tournament I feel like I did the best at and had the most fun.
I know, man. I think so me and you, yeah, and then we totally won the team tournament, the 3v3. You know, can't wait. Can't wait.
Won the raffle for the Chun-Li stick, you know, yeah. Right over there. I'll pull it up for you later.
Yeah, dude. Kotamu Uzume was there. She won the cosplay contest. It was pretty hype, man. Yeah. Pretty trill tournament, dude. Anyway, yeah, so that's like Street Fighter news. Mortal Kombat, if you guys follow Mortal Kombat, you know, I still follow it. Don't play it that much, but
Yeah, it's cool though.
They released the new trailer for the Combat. Was it the Combat Pack 2?
2.
Which is you know, I'm really excited for someone. But right now it's it was Alien, Leatherface, Borai Cho, and the robot, and I'm really excited for Borai Cho because you know when you're a kid,
cool,
yeah, when you're like a kid and you play, what did he show up in MK4 or Deadly Alliance?
Deadly Alliance.
When you're like a kid and you're playing Deadly Alliance and this guy's just farting and throwing up everywhere, like.
And you got that stick.
Yeah, this guy's a badass dude, and he's in this one, and then like his trailer, like it was pretty cool. He's just like drunk on the table, but then And then the robot is pretty cool because he's supposed to be, what, Sector? You know, this is how bad it is. What's it called when the three styles called again?
Variations.
The variations. There you go. I had so... Oh, yeah, that's how bad it is.
That's okay, man. That's why...
Yeah. And I guess the variations for the robot is, like, the yellow one, which is obviously Sector, yeah. Cyrax. And then the red one, which is obviously, you know, Sector. And then the last one's a gray one. And then people are saying that it's either Smoke, because there was a robot Smoke... Or some new character, Hydro, some stupid rain, I don't know. Or yeah, someone's also saying that it might be Noob Saibot, which would be pretty cool. Because apparently in the votes, you know, a follow on Twitter and all that shit, was like Noob Saibot was like one of the most wanted characters to be back. But then if you think about it, like MK, like character roster, there's so many characters and they're all bad. Like there are truly a lot of bad. There's so many badass characters in that game. And which one was it? Was it MK Marvel? Armageddon had all the characters in it, right? Like, yeah, right. Jesus Christ.
Fatalities, man.
Yeah. But nah, dude. Like, you know, of course it's a fighter, and I already have the game. I already bought the first combat pack. I'm obviously gonna buy
the second one.
I'm gonna get the second one. Try them out. Probably not gonna play any of them. Stick to my shitty Aaron Black. Doesn't even matter because the San Diego MK scene is like trash.
It imploded.
Cause it fucking just killed itself. I don't know how.
Joe,
we only had one tournament. It was the Rambat, and it was the greatest like Rambat ever. And then it's still going on in Greg's and Richard's head. So you know, yeah, Joe killed the scene when he took MK with him. Yeah, totally. But yeah, I don't know. MK was I had really fun playing that game. You know, we're playing it like every day. We had sessions dedicated to it, and then it just died. So bad. We even got Tong to play MK, dude. Like, what happened to it, Vincent? Tell me, please. Even though I know the story, but what happened to the MK scene?
I don't know, man. It just blew up. Where did it go?
Why? Where did the MK scene go? Chat, just like...
It was just us, man.
Just, where did the MK scene go, dude? Where did the MK scene go? All right, and then KOF is also coming out. I don't know when, but, you know, they said their graphics improved. But I can't wait to brush.
Leaps and bounds better every time, and we'll find out what it looks like on the 6th.
Yeah, man, I'll totally brush off my Pelican adapter so I can use my PS2 stick to play the game. But, you know.
My PS2 is still at Richard's house, but yeah. I'll get it back
in time. You know, I got two PS2s behind here. But, yeah, I'm excited. KI, I have no idea what's going on with KI because I don't own a fucking Xbox One. But, yeah. That's about it. What else, dude? That's it, right? Marvel. Dude, what the fuck? I don't know. Marvel is always... I feel like Marvel is the only game that never has news. New news. Like, there's never going to be another update. They're not going to make another one until, like, who knows when. And there's never, like, sick-ass events for it. There hasn't been a curly mustache in so long. Like, yeah, that game is, like, what the fuck, man? And everyone complains about, like, how that game's dead and all that shit. And then, like, I feel like the only reason it's dead is because, like, their players are, like, a bunch of bitches that complain about the game and don't go out and support their shit. But that's just me. I mean, San Diego has a pretty strong Marvel community of, like, nine people, you know? And then, like, the couple players from TJ. But, I mean, it's nothing like – yeah, they're pretty dedicated. But, I mean, it's nothing like – you know, it was cool last night at Wednesday Night Fights. They had, like, a 17-man tournament, you know? So that was a pretty cool – that was pretty trill, you know? Yeah. Besides that, I think it's, like – it's a pretty shitty community, man. And then I don't know. Who knows? Hopefully, you know, I only hope for the best for every fighter game, but you know what I mean? Like you know, Smash, great game to watch. Terrible people, you know. But nah, you know, in reality though, like I hope I really do wish the best for every fighter game. It's not, you know what I mean? It's pretty much when you start talking trash about other fighting games, it's like you're calling a nerd, like you're calling, like nerds are calling nerds nerds, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like even though it's really funny when people say that, but yeah, come on, like I'm not gonna call you a nerd for reading like Batman, and I'm over here reading like Batman and Robin. That doesn't make any sense. Who cares? Oh, anyway, but back to the topic. Those are all, you know, big news for Street Fighter is fucking Capcom Cups Sunday. Marvel, nothing's really happening. MK, the new characters are coming out. KOF is lurking. Tekken 7. I don't know when that's gonna come out. I really am truly excited for that game, but who knows when it's fucking coming out? But Master Cup just happened. If you guys don't know what Master Cup is, there was like 150 teams around there of five, dude.
And it was out of control.
That is a shitload. And I stayed up a good amount of the night watching that. And then like, it was out of control. The all girl team like dominated the fucking Bandai like support team, dude. Tekken, I don't know, the Tekken 7 community in like in Japan is always, it's so badass. Like I hate looking at pictures on Twitter of like the scenes in Japan that still use our arcade heavy, and it like makes me so sad that like, you know, I've enjoyed that era, but it makes me sad that like other people, like newer generations, are not gonna enjoy that era. But yeah, like just watch, like looking at the pictures, it's so cool, man. Arcade era was like the coolest era ever, and I'm glad like some people were there to enjoy it, while others, you know, sadly, all the new schools are going to miss out, sadly. And I'm not going to even say that there might be, like, another arcade. There probably won't be, Jesus. But, yeah, man. Rest in peace, you know. But, yeah, Tekken 7, fuck. Next week is the Master Cup, the World Cup, which is pretty much, I guess, the Capcom Cup of fucking, Tekken. So that's
so far.
It's next week. It's gonna be pretty cool. There's a lot of people. There are two representatives from America. Fucking Mr. Naps and Bloodhawk, which are like I get probably the two most dominated players. Well, you know, honestly, you don't know who the two most dominated players in America is because there's not that many fucking Tekken 7 setups, and no one can play it. And all the people that do play it are the ones dedicated enough to pay like $2 or a dollar at like Dave and Buster's or something. You know what I mean? That was cool. That round one had it, but it's gone. But shit happens. And then yeah, so that's what Street Fighter, Marvel, whatever. Yeah, who knows? Fighter games, they're gonna be there. They're gonna be here long. Anyway, you know what? So that was I don't know what this episode's about. I don't care. But
it doesn't have to have a point.
It doesn't have to have a point. But you know what? Was let me just tell you something. A couple Knuckle Dude, the homie Dude Dang, was here for in San Diego for 3 weeks for reasons I don't know of. Cause I don't know, wink. But dude, I got to spend at least a day with that guy. And that guy's a fucking badass. So before we go on to another topic, I just want to like the story I want to share with you guys is probably my favorite story to experience with him. It has nothing to do with Street Fighter. It has nothing to do with asking him questions about the scene. It just has. I didn't know that he was sponsored by Nissan and HTC. And then I guess HTC is like a phone company. And they gave him a phone. And it was his first phone ever. And then Tong drops his phone. The legendary Genghis drops his phone. And that was probably the most funniest thing that like cracked me up. And then like later on he brings up, yeah, this is kind of like my first phone. And then Tong's just like looking down like, I don't know. That was And that was my Knuckle Dude experience, dude. God cool bless guy. That guy. Cool guy.
Funny.
Really cool guy.
He laughed.
Shitty
jokes. He laughed. That's like the shitty Rufus Guile jokes that we were making. So yeah. He's cool.
He's a cool guy. He's a stand-up guy. Yeah. And then, man, what's going on with San Diego, though, man? You know, San Diego's been pretty quiet ever since after I can't remember what the last event. What was it? Fucking maybe not like San Diego 4 or San Diego State 4 was probably the last event.
The last big event was OFC at TTF.
You know what? That was okay. Yeah, because there was no TTF last Friday because there was a party in the USA.
Weird holiday, you know.
But yeah, you know what? Yeah, dude. The OFC was canceled because apparently, I didn't know that until now that OFC and or not OFC, SOS and the monthly only happened once a month. Well, obviously the monthly is gonna happen once a month. But I just thought that SOS was going to be every other week like it always was. But apparently that it's not. And then since there was San Diego State 4 and it was a big event and they needed to take a break after it, there was no other events Saturday at San Diego. So that pretty much just left us like with an open Saturday where we could have probably done something good for the community, you know, go out, spend time with real people or read a book. But I said fuck that. So we had SOS at TTF, and it became a pretty big success, man, because it was closer. You know, it was cool because TJ came out, because we're closer. And then we had the 2v2 random tournament, and we had like nine teams? Yeah, we had 9 teams of 2.
Yeah, I think so.
And if for you guys that don't know how the random tournaments work, we like if you're interested in the random tournament, we just put your name in a hat, and then the end of the whole, like, you know, when we're done with sign-ups, we pull 2 names out of the hat, and those 2 names are teams, and then you just, there, and that's your team, man. And then there was some pretty interesting teams. My favorite one was probably Team Never Salty, Audric and Will.
Yeah, pretty good.
And then Team Trill House, you know, Triox and Alejandro. What else was there? Who's Richard's partner? Oh, it's Greg. Greg. Yeah. Yeah. That was pretty funny. The grad team, MK Randbats.
Pretty good.
I had little Sebastian, even though I fucked up so bad and put the sombrero of death on his head. Vince and who was your teammate, Vince? It was someone funny. Or that was that?
Vince, man.
It was you and Vince. Oh, actually, you know, Rob's birthday team 2v2 was pretty funny because it was you and Will.
That was fun too.
Team Janet. You know, that's right.
Team best friends, man.
And then Yeah, so, and then before that, we had TTF Fundraiser. I forgot about that. You know what? This is a perfect time, dude. I want to thank everybody that came out to the TTF Fundraiser. And even though you didn't play, you still came out and showed support by being there. We did raise, we raised 140. We raised a good amount. And then, you know, like I said, that if we didn't make, and that's just not from the clapping, dude. That's not just from the tournament. It's also from the venue, from all the other events combined. But, you know, I paid the other half. And so we do now have another PS4 for TTF. We have 2 PS4s now. So then...
And 13 pizzas.
It's a new month. So starting tomorrow and then this Friday, next Friday, and the Friday after that, It's gonna be all the, you know, for our third PS4, and then this will be kind of like the final PS4 for TTF. There might be one more later on in the future for Tekken 7, but the plan is having three PS4s, two Xboxes. Cause I know for sure there will still be people playing Ultra, and there will still be playing Marvel. So I'm gonna hold on to some of my Xboxes, and we can only hope when Tekken comes out that people get interested in Tekken 7, and we can get that. And it's on something we can play. But so with that said, let's go over the schedule for TTF. Tomorrow at TTF is RANBAT 2.4. It was supposed to be last Friday, but there was the party in the USA happened. So tomorrow, hopefully, you guys can make it out to the RANBAT. The pot prize is at 154, I believe. It's some 54 bucks from the other RANBATs, and then I'm throwing in that sick $100 bonus. And then like obviously, if you don't want to play in the RANBAT, so you think it's too expensive, you're more than welcome to play some casuals. We should have some setups for casuals. And then next Friday will be Danger Room session number 4, because this Friday was supposed to be it, but obviously, you know, there was no TTF last Friday, so we're bumping up all the, you know, events. So Danger Room 4 will happen, and I believe I did say that I need 6 or more people. Is that right?
Yep. 6.
I need 6 or more people to enter it, or it won't happen. I mean, if you think about it, I mean, if it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. I mean, you can call me a scumbag or an asshole, but I mean, you're not really losing money, because the money goes to the house and the money goes to fucking the pot of the night, so that there's no, like, you know what I mean? Like, pretty much you just played in two, I guess, LDL tournaments. You played 5 for house and 5 for fucking, what's the word I'm looking for, Vince? 5 for the tournament. But anyway, but in the end, I do wish it does happen, because it is a TTF fucking event, so I wouldn't want a TTF event to fail, you know what I mean? And I am offering, like, a $300 pot prize in the end, you know what I mean? Because the 20 bucks you guys pay for, it goes straight to the bracket, the pot, and then the rest, I'm throwing in money, so why not? Why wouldn't you want to come? And it's a Marvel event in San Diego, so you know how Marvel's San Diego's all about Marvel, and you guys always want to play. There's a place to play, and there's fucking pretty much money thrown at you guys. And this tournament's not for everyone. You have to qualify for it, right? So, I mean, that sounds pretty cool. And so far, the fucking 6 people that are in it are all pretty badass. I mean, you got Dios Ex, and you got fucking Uncle Matt, Gollin, and Johnny, and fucking X Eliminator and Mr. Certified. Those are like 6 pretty badass players. I mean, fuck.
A lot of characters in there.
You know, I do feel bad because Earl, my name is Earl, messaged me. He thought there was going to be one tomorrow because him and Adrian wanted to come. But I said, unfortunately, I had to move it up a week, so he won't be able to make it out, which is, you know, sad. But it's cool that he wanted to come. But fuck, man. But yeah, it's a Marvel event. I'm throwing in, you know, money for you guys. You know, I'm not making shit off of any of these events, dude. You know what I mean? And if I do make money, it's not going to anything but the house. Fuck, what am I going to do? Spend, money on comics and pizza? But, no, seriously. So, like, all these events are for you. I mean, I'm not getting anything out of it. You know, the only thing I'm getting out of it is you guys fucking wrecking my bathroom and, like, leaving cigarette butts on the floor and, like, not paying for soda. So, you know, but I don't give a fuck, man. Who cares, dude? Just come. I want you guys to come, play, have a good time, and grind, dude. Because there's a difference between, you know, to some people, it's just a game. To others, it's like a passion. And then, you know, I'm here to provide services for both those people. For the people of 2, though, it's just a game. You're more than welcome to play casuals. For those people who are like the passion and everything, that's why I have the tournaments. But in the end, the house is open for the FGC for you guys to come play fighters and just hang out, dude. Because there's not that many places in San Diego to play, like, late night, especially now, you know. And then it's only going to get lower. I'm telling you that right now, man. You know. But hope you guys all show up Friday and then and next Friday for Danger Room. And with And with Danger Room sessions, there's always the 2v2 low roller, and those usually are more successful than a fucking Danger Room anyway, or any Marvel event. So, most likely, yes. So during Danger Room, we will have the. What I'm probably gonna do is, I'm probably gonna make the kitchen Marvel. I'm gonna make like 2 setups in the kitchen for Marvel, maybe 3, and then Tekken, because Tekken's been pretty cool, pretty good at TTF casual wise.
Yeah, pretty consistent.
And then we'll probably make the living room. You know what? We'll probably just make the living room street. Anyway, we'll figure it out. It's next week. But yeah. And then the week after that, we're having another fundraiser tournament. I hate to do this, but just because it didn't, the numbers and blah, blah, blah. I'm not going to have a Marvel one because there's only three people, like, four or three people interested. And that wasn't enough. And it sucks because, you know, me and Vince bought prizes for you guys. And a lot of the people seem to enjoy the prizes, man. It's the same prizes from the Big Kahuna plus the first place prize. But if you guys don't know, so next Friday, the Friday after next, not a good movie, but that'll be the donation tournament for the last PS4. Not the last PS4, but a PS4 for TTF. And
six pizzas, you know, to satisfy our cravings.
And it'll cost $10. It'll all go to the pot. Oh, no, yeah. They'll all go to the house pot, the venue fee. But top 8 does get prizes. And if you guys don't know the prizes, we'll tell you, man. Top 8 gets prizes. First place, you get that bag of Totino pizza rolls and a whole 12-pack of Dr. Pepper, all thanks to MLG Vincent and MLG Cody. Second place, you get that sick-ass bag of 12 Kerns. Third place is... how heavy is the bag of Sour Patch Kids? It's like 12,000-pound bag of Sour Patch Kids. Fourth place is the Sour Patch Kids, like I just said. Fourth place is the oatmeal, the dinosaur egg oatmeal. And then is third place oatmeal? Third place is the oatmeal, right? And fourth place is Sour Patch Kids. Yeah. And then, you know, just because you tied for fifth and seventh doesn't mean you go home empty-handed. Fifth place gets their Mountain Dew and Dorito fix. And then seventh place gets the real shit, which is the Big Lead Chew, which, yeah, BLC has became a major part of the Street Fighter community of San Diego to some of us.
Thank God for that.
But thank God for that. So those are three action-packed events. But the fundraiser tournament, I do think it is – no, it's not. Okay, no, because New Year's is going to be on a Friday. So hopefully we can have TTF on Friday and nothing's really happening on the first.
The New Year in the best possible place, TTF.
Yeah, dude, fuck it. Yeah, we should do that.
Good times, bad people, man.
Yeah. And other events in San Diego is always Land Diego Lounge does their things on Mondays, you know. Tuesdays.
Regrettably, I went through this Monday. It was a fun time.
Yeah, I was thinking of going, and then I laid down and didn't wake. And then
that was it.
And I didn't go.
Man.
Yeah, it happens.
It happens to the best of us.
Wednesdays, you can either sell your soul to the devil and go to the secret sessions. Or you can go to Wednesday night fights, you know. I think there's only one more left. And Thursdays is Smash at the Smash Brothers at the Salt Mines or Land Diego Lounge, whatever it's called. Jesus Christ. If you're a Smash 4 player, and I think they're starting Melee now. Melee. I don't know when, but they're starting Melee. So, yeah. They get like 80 people plus, 60 people plus. It's pretty crazy. Fridays is TTF, Dust Loop Fridays. You know, if you don't like TTF, if you're that rare person, there's a handful, there's a million of you guys. There's always TTF, there's no TTF. There's Dust Loop Fridays. Dust Loop Fridays fills your anime needs, so if you like anime fighters, sexual favors. Anyway, TTF. Dust Loop Fridays are every Friday at Land Diego Lounge, and they're all your anime fighter needs, and a lot of people there are all badass. Mitchell runs it, I think. We don't have Dio no more. We were talking about Dio. Dio, if you're in here, we were talking to you, man, about you. You're the best, dude. And then Saturdays is once in a while they have, I guess now it's like SOS or whatever. I don't know. There's probably, yeah. If I'm not doing anything Saturday and there's no SOS, I guess.
See you at TTF.
See you at TTF.
And we'll stay up for Sunday. We won't go to anybody's birthday. And then we'll watch Capcom come together and trick each other off.
Okay, let me talk. I'll tell you one thing. If there's no SOS this Saturday, I can't spell Saturday, I'll see you guys at TTF. Anyway, so, and then Sundays, there are session Sundays, but they're kind of on the low. For you guys who know, you know, all you have to do is ask that person, and they, he's usually pretty open, and he really wants to play. But besides that, there's not a whole lot going on. You know, we'll probably figure out something next week for you guys. We'll probably have a guest. It's been a while. We haven't had a guest in a while.
Yeah, we should do that sometimes.
You know, we can talk about Hearthstone. Dude, so, man, I finally got to rank 14 in Hearthstone. And it was not fun, dude. The last 2 days, if you guys don't know, I'm really big into Hearthstone. And a lot of you guys probably are. But, man, it took me 2 days to get to rank 14. And it's not like me playing just for an hour a day. It's I play like Hearthstone when I get home from work, like at 6, and I play until 12. So I wasted literally 6 years, 6 years, yeah, 6 whole years,
6 years of time.
aka hours of time, like trying to get to rank 14. And it was just me fighting between 15 and 16. And I was like complimenting life. I wanted to quit. I was about to like throw my computer out the window. But I finally did it today. But then you always have to remember that the beginning of the ladder is probably the toughest, like.
It is. It's just out of control.
Because everyone that hit legendary or everyone's just like in rank, like down there with you guys, man. It's like, it's pretty hard. But then I had a pretty good run today and I enjoyed it. And then I do love the game so much. And I'm proud to say that I haven't spent money on that game because the wings came out and I could have easily just put the 20 bucks down and like had all the wings. But I had enough gold saved up to buy all the wings, man. And so that's pretty cool. And then the new one came out today, so I have something to play later.
Yep.
And Oh, you know why I wanted to quit almost today? I lost to a Murloc deck, dude. And he didn't use any of the new. The only new Murloc card he used was like the little guy, the one for the 0/1.
The baby Murloc.
Yeah, and I wanted to kill myself. But anyway, yeah. God bless her. So, oh yeah, and that, you know, that's another. Oh yeah, but that's another thing we could talk about is yeah, when especially now is after like the Ranbats and Danger Room, like there's still gonna be TTF and there's still gonna be fighting game events, but I'm gonna focus a lot more on Hearthstone. So,
trying to get your girth fixed, you know?
We might not have that many low rollers. Like, we'll just have casuals until the end. You know, maybe like every last Friday we'll have you know, a tournament for Street Fighter or Marvel or whatever. And then like but the Fridays like before that we'll have Hearthstone tournaments. And we'll do like double elim and we'll do last hero standing. 'Cause you know, I do want to do Swiss 'cause I want everyone to get games in, but Jesus Christ, man, that will take so long. And for you guys, I don't know that TTF, we're like a late start program. We don't start tournaments and we open doors at 8 and we don't start until 9 or 10. But I mean, we do what we do and we have fun, man. It's thanks to you guys, man. It's thanks to the players, thanks to the scene, thanks to the people. If you guys didn't keep coming, there would be like no reason for me to be open, so there'd be no TTF. So you guys are really my, you know, my drive right now to keep this place going on, man, keeping it looking clean and sanitary and drug free for you guys. But no, I really I dude, yeah, I love you guys, man. I love all the I like, even though you don't know me or you never met me, but if you're like truly part of this scene, I love you, man. And you're like, you guys are badass, dude. There's a lot of interesting people in this scene, man, and we don't get to see them all, but you know, maybe one day we will see you at a tournament, man. Like, we got what's I don't even know his fucking name, dude. Jed, I think Jed is the guy that was Cream Pie Surprise on the Twitch channel.
Cream Pie?
And
Yeah,
then
you should have seen that guy on Monday, man. That guy is out of control.
Oh, was he there Monday? Nice.
Yeah.
And then
that guy, he's the one, dude. He's in the lineup.
No, that guy's badass because, dude, like,
I just invited him. He's in, dude. The whole
one day he was like, "Hey, where's this at?" And then he came over, and then he's been here every fucking Friday. I saw him at SCR. What did you do? Did you do something?
No, man.
But yeah, it was badass, dude. It was badass.
That guy's the one, man. That's all you gotta know.
But before we get into all this shit, man, the same talk is you know, stop complaining. If you're a little bitch, stop being a bitch. Come to events.
Yeah, play Yada aggressively.
Play Yada. I'm gonna get like a supercomputer. We're gonna play Yada. 'Cause I'll tell you one thing. If Yada was on like the Xbox or PS3, I already probably bought it. But it was supposed to be on like console, right? But they just like
yeah.
That's a shame. They lost someone more player. One less lonely girl in the world, man. But let's see. Yeah, before we get into the bitch callings and the callouts, I mean, I'm sorry. I don't wanna copy the homie Lord Aeris, dude. That guy's too cool. Before we get into the callout wall and I'm like messing with the picture of Vince and it's like pretty funny. Anyway, and our hot or not, or pretty much we haven't had a not, so let's call our the hot wall, you know? That sounds pretty gay. But, Vince, you want to add anything to the table? You want to say anything? You want to put your final words in before we release these faggots into the world?
See you guys Friday. See you guys Saturday. See you at all the bullshit. Go fuck yourselves. I don't know.
Go fuck yourselves, San Diego. Okay, so you know what? I always tell Vince to go first. So, you know, I'll go first. And I don't have anyone. So, Vince, you want to go first?
Yeah, man. What are we starting with?
You can call your call out wall.
Hard or not? You know what, man? He's been posting a lot of pictures lately. Chandler, Marky Mark, as Mark Wahlberg, young Marky Mark. He's the hot or not this week again.
Nice.
Which kind of pisses me off, but I feel like I have to do it. So. Yeah, and people who are shitty, who are bitches, is whoever the fuck was doing the commentary for that Celestial tournament in Hearthstone, man. Those guys are fucking garbage. And I'm just gonna, right now, while I have the chance, extend it to everybody that does commentary for any game. You guys all suck. I'm the best. And you guys all are garbage as fuck. And yeah, there we go.
Okay. All right. I like it. My, my call out is Konami as a company.
Those guys are garbage.
Like, it sucks because they, like, Konami, like, pretty much, like, gave a lot of us, like, our childhood with games such as, like, Metal Gear and fucking Silent Hill. And what else did Konami do? They did a whole lot, man. Jesus Christ. The Zombies Ate My Neighbors, you know.
And then they fucked up.
So, if you guys follow the sick, Totally Not Rigged Video Game Awards, fucking MGS Phantom Pain won 2 awards. But the whole time it was Keith Sutherland getting the awards. Shout out to Keith Sutherland, dude. That guy's a fucking badass. He was pretty much saying that every time he fucking does like signings and shit now, like he doesn't get like 24 posters or anything now. He always gets Lost Boy posters. Like he always gets like Metal Gear posters now. And then he pretty much said that like the MGS community is probably one of the strongest video game communities out there, or fan based communities, which is pretty cool. But, so the whole time Keith Sutherland was, like, there, and he kept saying that Hideo Kojima was supposed to be here, but he can't, he's, like, busy. And then the host straight up just, like, threw Konami under the bus, saying that the only reason that he's not here is because Konami, the company, wouldn't let him go out there because of some, like, company bullshit. So it's pretty much Konami's fault that Kojima wasn't there to get these badass awards.
It sucks. It's a joke, but it's real as fuck.
No, Konami's such a shitty company. You know, just in general, Japanese companies are pretty bad at like just throwing their workers under the bus, but I don't know. It's just whatever. But it's just how it works. And my hot or not is fucking what's her name? Stephanie Jostin. I don't know how to say her name, but she's the model that I'm just gonna do an MGS fucking thing. She's the girl they used for Quiet, the character Quiet in Phantom Pain. She's like, I think she's okay. 18. I don't know. Or older. I don't know. Who cares? Anyway, she's like Japanese and like
She's only 14 years old.
She's like from Denmark and she's like half Japanese and half European. She did the voice. She sings the theme. And she flew all the way to Japan to like perform the song. I don't know. Whatever. That goes out to her. But yeah, so Konami, you're a bitch ass company. And all the players who don't show up and complain about FGC shit, you can go to hell. You're eat a dick. There's a special place in hell for you guys. But with that said, see you guys all tomorrow. See you guys at every future event. Fanboy Gaming is Friday. They're pretty cool now. You know, they showed up on Friday for the first time. That was pretty cool. And they're always like giving me like a little plug-in, I guess, now every time they tell their things. You know, kind of a couple years too late, but yeah, it's cool for them, man. Hope you see you guys there Friday. I would go to those Friday. I've been to like a couple. They're pretty cool. It's just that, like, it's cool because, like, I don't really go to Fashion Valley, which is a mall, and it's at the Microsoft store. So, go out Friday. It kind of reminds me of going out to, like, Tilt to play video games and just hang out at the mall. So, yeah, if I didn't have TTF Friday, you know, I probably would go there. But I do have TTF on Friday, so just, you know, if you guys change your date, you know, I'll be there, dude. But, yeah, with that said, Vince, thank you, man. Always thanks to the fans. Thank all the fans or haters, I don't know. You guys always, you guys are what drive me with the rambling and shit. I'll probably be playing some, I can't stream it. Oh, you know what? Yeah, hell yeah. You know what? My reverse bit or shout out also will be, Little JFlow. I'm finally getting, like, a new video card. I don't know if it's good or not, but it's probably better than not having a video card. Sure. So I can start streaming again. And then, for sure, we're, like, around the, I know like it's so close, maybe tax return season, whatever they call it, like for sure I'll probably I'm gonna invest in like a super stream computer, because to stream from the PS, like streaming games from the PS4, like it's, dude, it like kills your, like, because you have to like lower your in order for me to stream on the PC, I have to lower like the I can't use 1080p, you know, I can't take full advantage of it, so I have to go like to 720, and it just looks so shitty. So I want to like make a supercomputer for that. But yeah, that's gonna happen. But besides that, I already said it again, but I'll say it always. Thank you, Vince, for being my partner in crime and pretty much holding the whole thing together. I'm pretty sure if it was just me, I would never get anything done, cause I'll just not remember anything.
You can't be all bad.
But with that said, One last time. Vince, you want to say, you want to put in your final words again?
Let's see. Oh, Ebony Goddess of the Week. I don't know who the fuck she is, but hold on. Let me get you. Let me link this real quick. I
guess it doesn't matter then, huh?
It wasn't Alicia Keys. It does matter. Everything matters.
None of this matters.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah, why not? All right. Whoever the fuck that is, thanks, Sean, for that. But, yeah, she's the Ebony Goddess of the Week. So good for her.
Good for her. All right. Well, she's like 14. Dude. Anyway, so, yeah, so see you guys tomorrow, and hope you guys all have shitty days, man. All right. Fuck yourself. Bye.
See you guys later.
Wait, I'm trying to say, you know, whatever. Yeah, I love you guys. Bye.
Thank you.